I'm going to discuss about the operon. So first, let's talk about the TRP or tryptophan operon. So in this case, what in case of tryptophan operon, we are talking about set of genes, and these genes are tryptophan E, TRP, E, TRP, D, TRP, C, TRP, B, and TRP. So we have several operons here. We have witnessed several operons that is going on here. And what is going on in this operon? It has one operator region, it has a promoter region. So the promoter, the first position, we have operator, so PO beside each other. So in this picture, and we have also another, it's a regulatory gene which produces a protein which is a repressor. And normally the repressor for this tryptophan is inactive or inactivated repressor. So what you are talking about here, the switch for making tryptophan is always set, normally set on position, because we need also so those bacteria need tryptophan as their nitrogen source. That's why they are producing tryptophan all the time. Okay, and to produce this tryptophan, they need to produce these enzymes, these five enzymes which helps them to helps in the synthesis of tryptophan. So when they do not have tryptophan, they need to go through all this, so the polymers, RNA polymers here is a bubble like structure. This RNA polymer has to go through all of these genes to cover this, transcribe all those genes, and finally make proteins out of it to help to make this tryptophan. But when we do not, when we have lots of tryptophan, then only we don't need to produce tryptophan. But that is a really, really rare condition. So in those states, when we have lots of tryptophan present, so those tryptophan has a binding site for this inactivator protein. So the tryptophan bind with that inactivator protein. For example, this is tryptophan. For example, tryptophan binds with this inactivator protein, and it sets this inactivator protein into an active form. So when it transfers that inactivator protein into active form, then this active repressor for tryptophan will bind to the operator region. And when this active repressor bind to the operator region, it stop the transfer, or it stop the scanning of this RNA polymers, and finally it stop and blocks the transcription process, and it blocks the protein production as well. That's why there is no tryptophan is present, no tryptophan is further made, because we have lots of tryptophan. So it's been economical for doing this. So in those cases, when you have lots of tryptophan in the cell, in the outside the cell can take those things, then they turn the switch from on to off using tryptophan. So what they are doing, they are using tryptophan to make the switch off in this case. Okay, so this is again, normally it is placed on, so it's a positive control over making tryptophan. If we look here in this case, so this is the RNA, this is the inactivated tryptophan. When the tryptophan bind with it, it the structural conformation change in the active repressor, it binds, RNA polymers cannot go through it. Okay, so the operon is off in this kind of situation. Now let's talk about an inducible operon in this case. What is it? We generally call it two types of operons. This is a repressible and an inducible. In this previous picture, in the case of tryptophan operon, whatever the binding of a specific repressor protein to the operator shuts off transcription, as we have not seen in this case, because binding of inducer in this case in the tryptophan, we have binding of repressor on the operon that stop the operon system, that off the switch for the operon system. And in the tryptophan operon, we have witnessed that. And in another set of operon can also be found when we induce the operon, when we switch on the operon. Normally in those operons, we have off in general times via repressor, and we can on this by adding what we call the inducer here. And in this previously cases, we have on normally, or generally we make the switch is on and the switch is made off by adding those repressor genes. Okay, so the example in this case was tryptophan, as we have discussed. But in the second case, we have example of lac operon. So when you're talking about lac operon or lactose operon in this case, so if you need to understand the operon, you have to understand a clear view that what is this operon is going to do. In the previous case, in the tryptophan operon, we are actually want to make tryptophan. That's the important thing to remember. If you remember that, what you need to do, then will be fine. So if you want to make a tryptophan in the operon scheme, then if you have tryptophan, you don't want to do that. You don't want to make enough any further tryptophan if you have tryptophan. That's why if you have tryptophan, then those tryptophan operon will be switched off. And in the other case, in the lactoferrin, what we are going to do, we are going to break down lactose. So we are going to break down it. So in this case, if you remember the breakdown of lactose, then you can measure if you have enough lactose, then you should make on this tryptophan. And if you're not having enough lactose, then you switch off this. If you have enough lactose, then you need to break that lactose down to make use of it, to derive energy from this.